Mickey Rourke's a bum, but Faye Dunaway's not picky in Barfly.
This week on At the Movies.
Tonight at 7:30 on Channel 9.
For thousands of years, ever since the beginnings of recorded history, a belief in witchcraft and sorcery has existed in the fears and imaginations of man. That among us are those imbued with supernatural and magical powers. That through rituals and secret ceremonies, their spells and curses could affect the weather, take over the will of the innocent, and control the powers of life and death. It is a very real belief in magic that gave us the basis for our legends, folklore, and classic fairy tales.
You poor simple fools, thinking you could defeat me, the mistress of all evil. Well, here's your precious princess.
We all seem to relish a good scare from tales of witchcraft and sorcery. Classic films like The Wizard of Oz and Walt Disney's Sleeping Beauty can still make any child want to keep his light on for at least one night. And we can comfort them by telling them that it's all just make-believe. But it really wasn't all that long ago that our ancestors feared what we now enjoy as a scary story, a scriptwriter's imagination, or a special effects man's expertise. There was a time that witches, wizards, and others who possessed the power of true magic had most of mankind cowering in terror.
Well now, the good folks at Quaker Oats tell us we could eat oatmeal for 11 days in a row and never have the same flavor twice. Well, we could. They got the 11 flavors and they're all good. But my little pal Laurie here wouldn't want to go 11 days and only have maple and brown sugar once. Now, would you?
Nope. Stop that.
Quaker instant oatmeal. Well, it's the right thing to do and the tasty way to do it, isn't it?
I think when you start to design a car, you begin with a person. You think about the person you're designing for, and then you design the car around it.
There are other people involved. There are mother-in-laws involved. There are kids involved.
It's about individuals. It's about how they feel. It's about their egos.
Right. What we're doing is humanizing technology by approaching it from a human standpoint.
I hate to sound like a cliche, but you are what you drive.
You sound like a cliche.
Oh, stuck.
Nissan, built for the most important race of all, the human race.
When they're soaked in, penetrating, when they're protein stains, you need the power to cut through. The protein power of Era Plus. This grape stain is made of protein, and protein gets out protein. And look, Era even has the power to cut through the ground-in dirt below. Nothing gets out every stain, but you've got Era Plus. Protein power to cut clean through.
Oil Express presents a fast 10 minutes.
A quick hello and off they go, hopping around the hood. Draining out that dirty oil, my engine feels so good. You can choose the oil to use, any brand or weight. Oil Express, I got the best, my very favorite's Quaker State. Check. Power steering, brake, transmission, battery, differential. Working and a squirting in those fluids, so essential. Tires, filter, safety check, you think they're finished yet? A smile and a handshake can. You're out the door, no sweat. Oil Express.
Goodwill Industries can make a big difference to someone with a disability. Goodwill trains people with disabilities, counsels them, helps them to find a job and hold it. If you're disabled and you want job training, or if your business needs a reliable source of skilled, motivated employees, contact your nearest Goodwill office.
Odd kind of place.
Who'd your folks get it from, Boris Karloff?
The weather brings out creativity. It helps me in my work.
What kind of work is that? Witchcraft?
Witchcraft. The very name promises an encounter with evil. In reality, it is an offshoot of pagan religions dating all the way back to the Stone Age. Practitioners believe in the power of nature and of the mind. But at one time or another, in all cultures of the world, fear of the unknown and superstition turned them into villains of the most wicked kind. In the imaginations of man, witches have appeared in many different forms. In Greek and Roman mythology, a witch was often a beautiful seductress. A more familiar concept comes from Europe during the Middle Ages. The witch as an old crone or hag, whose ugliness is a reflection of the ugliness within her own wretched soul. Then there is the witch as a magical creature akin to fairies and gnomes. They live deep within enchanted forests. And it was even thought that these mischievous beings may have had a special internal organ from which their magical powers emanated. Shared in common was the dedication to use their magic to bring on the willful torment and destruction of mankind. Before there was the science of medicine, witches were the closest thing to doctors. People who were ill would search out a witch, hoping to be cured by a magic spell or a concoction of herbs. Other services they would perform included casting spells on an enemy or competitor, making charms and talismans for luck, and to keep troublesome spirits away. And they were also specialists in affairs of the heart, and created powerful love potions. In Europe, beginning in the 14th century, it was believed, as this scene from the 1903 production, The Red Spectre, suggests, that witches were deriving their powers from an association with the devil himself. It was feared that witches were responsible for all the ills befalling mankind, including the Black Plague that was sweeping across the land. It was this terror of witchcraft that created visions of fiends who would steal babies and rob corpses from their graves to use in their foul and deadly brews. It was believed that their souls could leave their bodies to join with other phantasms and demons to wreak havoc and destruction. It was also thought that witches had the ability to fly, usually on a broomstick. This ability was called transfection, and it would be accomplished by rubbing their bodies with flying ointment. It is suspected that these concoctions contained drugs that were absorbed through the skin, and the result was hallucinations of midnight flights. On special days, witches would take to the air and meet deep within a forest. These gatherings were called sabbats, and witches from all over the land would frolic and revel in their wickedness. Mostly, witches were believed to be female. Stories of male witches, known as warlocks, are much less frequent. But, given that all witches have the powers of transformation...
Come here.
Maybe it is just impossible to tell which witch is which.
My life, my blood shall bring life.
It is with the use of black magic and sorcery that the powers of darkness could be summoned in the form of goblins, gremlins, and other malevolent creatures of the night.
Don't fear it, Ahmed. It is our friend.
Witches and sorcerers were often surrounded by what appeared to be common domestic animals. These animals were called familiars and were suspected to be a lesser demon or imp in disguise. Witches would often transform themselves into animals, including vampires and werewolves. There is also another creature of legend that was created by the magic from only the most powerful sorcerers.
Dragons. Oh, dragons are most impressive, but they seem rather easily slain. In the black arts, something as simple and unimposing as a figure carved in wax or made of cloth can be just as deadly and far more insidious. Of course, the use of such dolls and likenesses is most closely associated with voodoo.
Natives that live in the lands where voodoo is practiced are very careful when disposing of old clothing, fingernail clippings, and hair trimmings. They knew that if any of this should fall into the wrong hands, it could most certainly mean their demise.
Fair gypsy, leave my fortune. What do you see in the glass?
I see happiness. I see love. Far more than you deserve.
Is that all?
No. I see...
What's wrong? Oh. Madeline. Madeline.
1974, there was an official decree issued in Europe that ordered the destruction of anyone who practiced any form of witchcraft or black magic. Of course, today, we know that much of what was blamed on witchcraft was the result of natural phenomenon, or that actual crimes had nothing to do with supernatural powers. But fear had overpowered reason. No one was safe from suspicion, and it was almost impossible to prove innocence. Grisly forms of torture were devised that could force a confession out of anyone, guilty or not. The most famous figure in history to be found guilty of witchcraft was Joan of Arc. She suffered the same fate as the rest. The witch hunts of Europe lasted just about three centuries, ending in the late 1700s. It is estimated that at least 500,000 people were executed. As the mass hysteria subsided, the witch finally found its place in storybooks and fairy tales.
There once was a competition to create the greatest doll in all the land for the daughter of the king.
Carpaccio's doll can talk.
Yes, but he doesn't know children. Julie?
Yes?
A doll that knows when it's hot or cold, light or dark.
Ooh, it's getting brighter.
And understands what you say.
Grandpa, can she play with me?
I like to play. What can we do?
She understands you.
Shh, quiet.
Are we making too much noise?
Julie, can you sing? Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
She's amazing!
Are we going somewhere?
We're taking you to the king.
We're not going anywhere.
But, sir, the doll. No one will know.
One person will.
Finally, a doll that understands you. Julie, the greatest doll in all the land.
Get ready for Spiral's Nacho Cheese Corn Snacks.
Spirals are gonna turn your taste around with every nacho bite. The wildest nacho snack you've ever found.
Spirals are gonna turn your taste around.
Move over, flat nacho chips. Now Spirals are here, specially shaped to give you a burst of zesty nacho cheese flavor in every bite. Spirals Nacho Cheese Corn Snacks.
Spirals are gonna turn your taste around.
Strap your snowboards on, grab a stick of juicy fruit. The taste is gonna move ya. Take a sniff, pull it out. The taste is gonna move ya when you pop it in your mouth. Juicy fruit is gonna move ya. It chews the salt, it gets right to ya. Juicy fruit, the taste is gonna move ya.
Have bugs and pests taken over your house, forcing you to flee to the comfort of your own home? Well, your troubles could be over with Super Bug Away, the safe and easiest way to rid your home of most bugs and pests. Super Bug Away emits powerful ultrasonic sound waves, causing pain and discomfort in the nervous system of most bugs and pests. Super Bug Away's ultrasonic sound cannot be heard by humans and household pets except hamsters, gerbils, and mice. Super Bug Away effectively protects up to 2,500 square feet of partition space on one floor. Just plug it into any electrical outlet and let it do its work for only pennies a day. Use Super Bug Away in place of sprays, powders, and chemicals. The sooner you call this toll-free number, the sooner you and your family will be pest-free with Super Bug Away.
Call 1-800-227-9989 now. That's 1-800-227-9989. Or send check or money order to Super Bug Away, P.O. Box 2727F, Grand Central Station, New York, New York, 10163. That's 1-800-227-9989.
Thank you.
From almost every ancient civilization come stories of sorcerers, wizards, magicians. Unlike witches, their powers were not necessarily used for evil purposes. In fact, their abilities would be sought after by warriors and kings to help defeat enemies and foretell the future. For instance, what would have ever happened to King Arthur if the great Merlin hadn't been by his side?
In most legends, the truly great wizards were quite elderly. That is, because the art of wizardry is learned, not a natural ability. It would take years of acquiring knowledge and experimentation before a wizard dared to try any great feats of magic. This is because, to gain some of his powers, he must conjure up a spirit to help him. Even for the most experienced wizard, this could prove to be dangerous, for no spirit is to be fully trusted. The wizard was willing to take these risks because it was his responsibility to hone his magical skills to enable him to combat the evil spells of witchcraft. Sometimes this would mean a one-on-one encounter, which could prove to be most amusing if viewed from afar.
What's going on?
They're having a wizard's duel.
One, two, three, four.
Merlin, she disappeared.
Huh? Ma'am, now, you made the rules.
In this scene from The Sword in the Stone, a kindly old and befuddled Merlin must test his magic against a malicious old witch named Mim.
Come on, something bigger.
Something smaller.
Wash me, will you? Merlin.
Ouch! Oh, bravo!
Oh, just you wait. Just you wait. You're gonna pay. So you want to play rough, do you?
Gone through the skies on a fog of doom. Now go with a curse and serve me well. Round Stefan's castle, cast my spell.
In Sleeping Beauty, Disney's animators created a personification of evil so powerful that she was impervious to any other form of magic. It is then, when there seems to be no hope, that goodness in all its purity is ready to valiantly come face to face with impending doom.
No. Shall you deal with me, O prince, and all the powers of hell?
And it is these confrontations between good and evil that is the lasting appeal of all the folklore and fairy tales that have been passed down generation after generation. That wickedness will ultimately be defeated, and that even the most weak and innocent will
triumph.
To keep an eye on the kids was all she said.
Splash, splish.
There's a kid in the fish.
But who's got eyes in the back of his head?
Gotta get a steak, gotta get a Twix.
Chocolate, caramel, satisfaction. Like to be cookie, let's just stand the action.
Won't
slow you down when you gotta get around.
Twix keeps you hopping while you mop, mop, mopping the floor.
They move the Twix right out the door.
Keep on
moving with Twix.
Stack a snowball down, grab a fruit. Snap, pull it out.
It's the Battle of the Rosies.
This Rosie's got the big town.
This Rosie's got the quicker one, Bounty.
And they're off.
The Rosie!
Bounty's the quicker picker-upper. See?
I'm going to change my towel, Rosie.
But not your name, Rosie. Hey, come here. Smell anything? No, that's because this towel was washed with new unscented liquid Tide. It's 100% perfume free. New unscented liquid Tide. All you smell is clean.
Ships of old took us places we had never been. Now new ships are taking us places we can never go. To the worlds of the infinitely small, the infinitely large, and the universe within. Journey with the infinite voyage to unseen worlds. Part of Digital Equipment Corporation's Digital Discovery Series. It's television that brings you the wonder of it all.
Watch The Infinite Voyage, Monday at 7 on Channel 9.
Today we are still intrigued by magic. But we all know that it's a bit of showmanship and a little sleight of hand. True magic in the tradition of superstition and folklore has been trapped in time in the ruins of antiquity. Science and technology have become the modern versions of magic. Or did you ever wonder that maybe, just maybe, there is one survivor from the time of myths and legends?
My love. Once more, for old time's sake. What was that?
Suddenly, given just the right moment, we may again find ourselves in an age of magic and enchantment.